Hey y'all, I was just going to talk to you today about abuse. It comes in many forms. It comes in physical abuse, mental abuse, verbal abuse, sexually abuse. Many people has went through one type of this abuse throughout their lives. I've been through all of them. And thankfully, you know, since I've met my husband, I have been protected from abuse. But some of my friends has come to me and they're in a mental abuse relationship or a physical abuse relationship, or they're in a physically abusive relationship. Sometimes couples are together and they're actually in a sexually abusive relationship where their sex life is not healthy, you know, and nobody has control over you. You know, you own your own body. You own your own self. You own your own person. Nobody owns you, you know. You control who you want to verbally abuse you or sexually abuse you or physically abuse you or mentally abuse you. You don't have to be in this situation. Those people that do this to you, they have low self-esteem. They want to pick on somebody that's weaker than they are, you know, and stand up to them, you know. Do what Medea does. Get you a frying pan full of grease and throw it on them and bop them upside the head, you know. Do whatever you have to do to get out of that situation, you know. Call your friends, call your family members, call somebody, you know. They don't love you if they hit you. They don't love you if they sexually abuse you. They don't love you if they physically abuse you. They don't love you if they mentally mess with your head. That is not love. You know, that is not love. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is generous. Love is giving. Love is just love, you know? I mean, abuse, hate, anger, vengeance, strife is not love, you know? Please. This guy or this girl does not love you if they give you any kind of grief or abuse. You know, me and my husband, I have told him and myself, wait 15 seconds before we say anything to each other if we are mad, because those words hurt. Words cannot be taken back. You know, when you say something to somebody to hurt them, you could say you're sorry all day long, but they will not forget that. They will not forget those words. Words cut you like a knife. They can either hurt you or they can help you. Words are the worst thing that you can have in a relationship, because they can be good or they can be bad for your relationship. And guys, all you men out there, women do not forget. Let me repeat this. Women do not forget anything. Anything you say to her, she will not forget. Sure, she'll forgive you, but she will never, ever forget. Every word that you plant inside her head is going to stay there. You know, so be careful when you choose your words. And women, don't just lash out at him, you know, and say mean things to him because you're mad. You know, that's the worst time that you can ever talk to somebody, is when you're mad or when you're angry. You know, and that could stop a lot of mental abuse right there. You know, nobody should have control over you. You know, you should be able to go when you want to, but be, you know, considerate and say, I'll be back at 4 o'clock, so they'll know what time you're going to come back, you know. And don't do things that will jeopardize your relationship, like go out to the bars and party all night long when you're married, you have kids, you know. You're committed to a relationship. You're committed to your husband or your wife, you know, and just compromise in a relationship. You know, always include your spouse. I try not to get any friends unless my husband can become friends with them too, you know, because he's part of me, you know, and that's just the way it is, you know. And but I wanted to read you a story about abuse, you know, that I wrote. That's a little snack of the story. And I'm going to be adding to it, but I just wanted to give you an idea about what Kendra went through. and it's called Behind Closed Doors. Kendra was only 22 years old when she met Chris, the love of her life. Everything between them was great, and her friends were jealous at the attention Chris gave her. What they didn't know is what went on behind closed doors. This is where the beating started, and the beginning of the relationship was like a dream. Chris wined and dined Kendra, bought her diamonds, took her to expensive restaurants, even randomly sent her flowers for no apparent reason. He was every woman's dream. Kendra even took Chris home to meet her devoted Christian parents. After a week of dating this charming man, Chris knew how to work his charm, too. He treated Kendra's mom, Linda, with the same grace he treated his beloved girlfriend. He helped Kendra's father out restoring an old 64 Mustang that has been sitting in the garage for years. Kendra knew what to do to win trust over ordinary people. He just had that personality. But nobody really knew the Chris that was behind closed doors. After 18 months of dating, things went from bad to worse for Kendra. She lost tons of weight. She started wearing baggy clothes. She no longer had that sparkle in her eye. She grew increasingly unaware of how she looked to others. It was like someone else controlled her, dressed her, fed her, and told her how to live her life. One day, Chris told Kendra they needed money, and he suggested she work for him. It would only be a couple hours a night, and she could make them a couple $100 a night. Kendra was willing to do anything behind closed doors, but putting herself on the street corner pleasing other men was something she refused to do. This was the first and last time she ever stood up to Chris. Kendra felt the blow of his fist as she slammed up against the wall, blood dripping off her swollen lip. She was a little girl laying there in a fetal position as Chris kicked her in the side and told her she would do what he says whether she liked it or not. This was the beginning of the nightmare for Kendra, behind closed doors. One night, Chris came home in a happy mood, very unusual, and this made Kendra wonder if he was changing like he promised her. Every other beating she got from him. Kendra had a nice dinner cooked. The house was clean. Her hair was combed just how he liked it. She was even wearing his favorite perfume. She tried so hard to please this impossible man. Carly, Kendra's 4-year-old daughter, was visiting her too. Her parents needed a break, so they asked Kendra to keep her for a few hours. In Kendra's eyes, sitting down to dinner with her baby girl, her dream man was the best day ever. Later that evening, while Chris was watching television, Kendra snuggled up to him. Caressing his hand, she noticed a burn mark on his fingers. She asked him what happened, thinking they came from working on the old Mustang. Chris became quiet, then agitated. To calm him down, she reminded him she would have to get ready for work soon and take Carly back to her parents. She knew money always made Chris happy. The next morning, she came home from work and kicked off her 5-inch heels. She noticed a pipe on the bathroom counter. It was a small copper pipe with burn marks on it. She'd never seen it before and wondered if maybe it belonged to one of Chris's buddies. So she put it away and went to bed. She was sleeping soundly, snuggled up to her dream man when she was awakened by someone beating her. At first, she thought she was dreaming. She fought back, trying to wake up from this nightmare, screaming for Chris to help her. She had no idea that he was a person that was making her life a living hell. She thought everything changed. He promised her. They were at dinner as a family the day before. Why would he do this to her? She made him $300 the night before just for him. As usual, Chris apologized and said he didn't know what came over him and asked her where his pipe was. She handed it to him and he said, "I guess you know now." And she said she thought it belonged to his friend, Ollie. Chris told her that it was his, and he has been smoking crack for the last year and couldn't stop. He admitted pimping her out to supply his $200 day habit, when all along she thought he was using the money for school and to restore the Mustang for healthy profit. Kendra spent 2 years with this monster behind closed doors. He beat her, burned her with cigars, shot her with a BB gun, and told her she was nothing but a paycheck to him. And she believed him when he said he was sorry. Kendra realizes the day she handed him back his crack pipe was the day she escaped from behind those closed doors. She left that monster and the daily beatings and the insults that slammed the door for good. Kendra is alive. I hope you enjoyed that story. And if you're in an abusive relationship and you know me personally, get a hold of me. I will help you get away. I will find you an escape. I will, don't worry about what that man says or if he promises you or that he'll never beat you again. There's a lot of men that are in abusive relationships too. You know, women beat on men too. You know, I'm not just picking on the men here, but women are also abusers too. So if you're in any kind of abusive relationship, that is not healthy. That is not healthy. Get away while you can. Get away while you are alive. Your children do not need to see any kind of abuse going on in your home. They will repeat that pattern with their spouses. You are raising them up the way that, you know, they need to go. You know, the way that you raise them up is a reflection on your parenting. So if you need any kind of help, just reach out to somebody. Everybody cares about you. You have family members that care about you. You have friends that care about you. I care about you. Reach out to me. I hope you enjoyed the story. Have a good day. Love y'all.